Today, we're going to be talking a little bit about how to use Claude to design applications. Claude recently released Artifacts. Artifacts is an incredible way to be able to like interactively create web applications. You're able to create like React components, which are components that could live on a website very easily. And so this like capability that Claude has of us like quickly prototyping something that's like real that you could take and immediately put on a website is really incredible. So we're going to talk about, even if you're not somebody who normally knows how to code, somebody who maybe is less familiar with this stuff, I'm just going to give you a kind of a brief overview about how you create a style that'll allow the components that you build to be really like reusable. So even if you haven't really coded before, I'm going to give you a template to go through about how to take a style that you like or a style that you think is interesting, create it, iterate on it, build it out, and be able to use it to create new components and new ideas. Because I think like the style of what you build is like really important. I've previously done a lot of work around design systems, and design systems are effectively a way of being able to create a definition of a design so that it can be like reused across an entire application. I think design systems are really powerful for enabling creatives and designers to build a very reusable tool set. And I think honestly, they're the right way to approach this thing, thinking about Claude and thinking about what Claude can do. All right. So what we're going to do now is we're going to effectively start trying to define a design system around an application. The application we're picking is going to be actually Starbucks, their application. They've got like a pretty unique brand. They've got good colors. And so we're going to try to reproduce this brand using this approach to generating a design system using Claude. We're going to tell it, hey, act like a design system expert. We're going to analyze this screenshot of our application. And please help me extract this these style variables that are helpful to reproduce this style across a bunch of the components of our application. So I tell it fonts, colors, spacing, rounding, try and come up with the CSS variables that make sense for this. So here are the kind of output colors there. And so what I'm going to say now, we've got some basic colors, but it'd be nice to like really fill this out a bit more. So what we're going to do is we're going to say, hey, okay, expand on these colors a bit more. Let's be sure to define how these colors should be used. Like the definition of like how we use things is really important for defining a design system. So we're just going to ask it, hey, let's expand on that a bit. So now that we've got the colors, we've got the typography, spacing, rounding, icons, that all looks really great. Let's get the font. I'm going to say, hey, get the font that's most similar to this screenshot that is available on Google Fonts. Once you get that, let's take that font, add a definition for it using a link tag and basic CSS snippets that can be used to use it on a font for a website. So we're going to do that. We're going to generate it. So you can see here, it's like cool. Roboto looks pretty similar to me. Let's go ahead and add that guy. Okay. So now that we've got our style guide defined, I really want to see it. I'm like, this looks great. Can you take our style sheet and use it to build a style guide using Tailwind to highlight the guide visually to display color, spacing, and other properties? I want to see the output in artifacts because that's like really key to like how we're going to be visually seeing things. Remember to define the colors as CSS. Don't use these inline colors specified like this or Tailwind classes specified like this. Many Tailwind features do not work in artifacts. So I'm just telling it like, I really love Tailwind because it keeps things short and concise. It's a great tool for being able to like preview things and generate stuff with AI, but I don't want to see it in artifacts sometimes because we can't use the advanced features of it because it just doesn't work in artifacts. So I'm also telling it again how to output the font. So let's go ahead and generate this. It's pretty touchy. So that's one of the things, like a lot of these details that I'm defining and a lot of definitions here, we're really going to have to be specific with how we're generating it because sometimes some of this stuff just doesn't work. So that just failed. And a big reason is because I didn't say to use React for it. So here we go. We're going to get our style guide defined in here. You can see that it's really trying to kind of generate things out. The problem is it's got some of these things done, but it's really not defining things. Okay. So I've done this a couple times. I've ran through this whole thing a bunch, but every time there's just some stuff that you end up needing to tweak and play with a little bit. Defining these is always going to be a bit tricky to just get it defined the right way the first time, how to tell it like what things to keep in mind. Artifacts is like completely new, so there's still a lot of this that's going to be built out. But this is a prompt that sort of seems to be working well for me. I needed to define it, tell it a bunch of times that we're still using artifacts. There's a lot of the stuff that needs to be defined that way, but now it's doing a pretty good job. And this is like what you want to see. And we can actually start using this as like an example now. This is good text that I want to keep in mind. So we've got this style guide here. It's got all these definitions. It looks really great. Okay, great. That looks awesome. Let's take this and generate a markdown file with all of the details of our design system in it, how each of these things should be used. Don't need to group it into a table for now. Just do sections, variables, that sort of thing. What it's going to do here is it's going to start coming out with the different components, how things should be defined, what all the values are, that kind of thing. It's going to go ahead and come up with our design system, some of the best practices, all that sort of stuff. So here we've got our app design system for Starbucks. We've got our primary green, black, all the different colors here. We've got our typography specified, how things should be done there. We've got our font sizes, spacing, all that stuff. Cool. This is a nice document that we could be using. I also just really like the application code that we defined a little bit earlier here. I think this actually might be sometimes more helpful than the other code specification here, but this is just more legible. It's easier to understand, and it includes some of the usage guidelines that honestly the other one doesn't have. You can try and like play with combining the two, how that works, but these are two ways of getting that output. And you might just define both of these and throw them both at your application, but now you've got these two documents. So I'm going to now say, cool, now that we've got this Starbucks design system, I'm going to say, hey, can you give me this? Can you give me a hero banner to promote my new product for a cat food company? And it's going to go through here. We're going to start generating out some stuff. So we've got our cat food hero banner here. We've got our different styles that are going to be defined. This is doing a lot of styles defined very explicitly. I feel like this is going to become a problem a bit here. And you can also see something started happening. So what I've done here is I've taken now this code that we've gotten here. I've had to iterate on it a bit because there's still some challenges where it doesn't now know what to include, how to do colors, these sorts of things. It starts to take liberties. So you have to keep reminding it like, hey, use our design system colors, how you just define the different colors and the things, how you define the fonts and different things. So a lot of this just needs to be defined that way. So now we've got a banner for our cat food product, very Starbucks style. Can you now build an entire page around this banner? So now we're going to go through, we're going to build the whole page. And you can see a lot of the different parts of the page getting built here. It's all getting added and combined. It is referencing the hero banner. It isn't including the hero banner, but it looks like that ended up working pretty well anyway. So we've built this entire page now around this sort of brand identity. We've got different components here that are for our pet food brand. And we've got some links that kind of look very Starbucks-esque. And we can start tweaking it already, right? So it's like, instead of the links at the top, can use some icons. Let's try and generate it with those. And it's still going to output everything, which is awesome. I definitely was a little worried about that, but we're going to output it all again. Cool. So now we can start tweaking things, and like you can see it's all coming together a little bit. Now we can start tweaking things. We can start playing with it. We can start seeing like what we can change to make things a little bit better. And now you've got this kind of Starbucks-esque pet food brand company going. And this is all within this one output, right? So we built our design system in context. We've got all the screenshots in context, all that stuff's there. But do you want to have all that context in order to build a new component? Let's see if we can do that now. So now what I've done is I've basically taken the style guide component that we've created, the design system markdown that we've created. I've asked it to act like a React and Tailwind developer proficient with using design systems, and to take our existing design system and let's apply it to build out a new date picker component. And so this is now your kind of Starbucks styled date picker component. You can move between the different days. It doesn't look like we can select anything or do anything, but we've been able to just bring these designs across, and now we've started developing new components completely on their own. And we had that previous question that we already had where we were asking, hey, is there a way for me to generate this hero component? Let's try and generate that same hero component again. Awesome, this looks great. I'm interested in building a hero component for my application using this style guide. Can you also create a component for me using the same kind of method? And you got your hero component here, which is very weird looking. And I guess that's probably because it doesn't have a title or anything being defined. So I'm basically gonna say, cool. I took that component, didn't seem to be outputting stuff, but let's create it and I'll put it all in one place so I can see it. And now we've got our perfect nutrition guide for your feline friend, premium all cat food tailored for your cat's unique needs. And so yeah, now we're on our way. We've got our style guide defined with those two files at the top. We're able to create new components using these style guides as a definition that we can take and keep building out with. So this is a pretty extensive deep dive into doing this. It's still getting developed out. There's still a lot of this that's up in the air as a question, but this gives you a starting point on like how to develop components with this that feel right. They feel like your application. They feel like something that kind of actually fits what you're trying to do specifically. All of this is going to be included on our blog on Stable Discussion. You should be able to see on Stable Discussion, there's going to be a rundown of all the code that we went through today, how to do this and like what the outputs looked like. So that kind of step-by-step might be a little bit easier to follow, but this gives you a feel for the actual struggle of kind of building it out. Thanks for tuning in. Thanks for stopping by. We'd love it if you'd subscribe, follow us on Stable Discussion, and find out more about us there. So thanks so much. Have a good one.